A very good morning all of you. Welcome to lecture number 31. It is the second part of the multiplexer in which we are going to see how to construct the higher order marks using the lower order marks, like 8 into 1 using 4 into 1 and 2 into 1. And we are going to see applications of multiplexers, like different applications. Then we are going to see IC multiplexer 74151 and also 74157 multiplexer and their simulation in the multisim software. Now we'll try to see how to design higher order marks using lower order marks using lower order marks. So first we'll take the first problem. Designing 4 into 1 marks using 2 into 1 marks. So what you do is, for a 4 into 1 multiplexer you need 4 inputs. So I'm going to take 2 inputs for 2 into 1 marks and another 2 inputs for another 2 into 1 marks. That means my D0, D1 I am going to give for the first multiplexer, and D2, D3 I am going to give to the second multiplexer. So I am going to take first 2 into 1 marks here. So here I am going to apply my D0 and D1, and I am going to take one more 2 into 1 marks, since I am supposed to use only 2 into 1 marks. So I am going to take my D2 here and D3 here, and this also 2 into 1 mark. So I have a select line here and one more select line here. Now I'm going to take one more 2 into 1 mark. This is very important. I'm going to take this and giving here as, and similarly one more input to here, and this is another select line for this one. So now your circuit is able to have 4 inputs and 1 output. Now the only thing you need to wisely decide your select lines names and their this thing. So I'm going to make my third 2 into 1 marks as S1 and these two as S0. Please listen carefully. We are going to design 4 into 1 multiplexer using 2 into 1 multiplexer. I took total 3 multiplexer. First multiplexer I have taken D0 to D1 bits, second multiplexer I have taken D2 to D3 bits, and I have taken one more multiplexer where I am going to take the outputs of the first two multiplexers and with a select line. Now you are supposed to choose wisely your numbering. S0 is my LSB, S1 is my MSB. If I take 0 0, if I take 0 0, when S0 is 0, your D0 will transfer here, as well as your D3 also will D2 also will transfer here. Please remember, when S1 and S0 are 0 0, you are going to it's going to activate D0 as well as D3. Okay, and when D0 D3 reach to the, let's say, let's make it numbering, this is the first multiplexer, this is second and third multiplexer. So D0 D3 will be inputs for the third multiplexer. In third multiplexer your select line is 0. When select line is 0, it is supposed to transfer only your D0. That means when you keep S1 0 and S0 also 0, you are going to transfer your D0 to the output side. Similarly, when you take S1 and S0 as 1 1, so if you take both as 1 1, you are going to activate your D1 and D3. I'm sorry, this is D2. Now let's try to see. Now let us try to see based on the select lines how your 2:1 multiplexer act as a 4:1 multiplexer. Let's take S1 and S0 here. When you take both 0, 0, when take both 0, 0, for the first multiplexer your D0 output will be activated, and second multiplexer your D2 will be activated. These will be applied to the third multiplexer. A third multiplexer S1 is 0, select line 0. In that case your D0 will be appear at the output side. Similarly, when take 0, 1, when you take S1 equals 0 and S0 is 1, in that case your D1 will be activated as well as D3 will be activated. These two input will be given to the third multiplexer. For the third multiplexer, select line is 0, so that means your D1 will be transferred to the output side. Similarly, when you take 1, 0, your D0 as well as D2 will be transferred to the third multiplexer. But for third multiplexer, S1 is 1 this time. When S1 is 1, you are supposed to activate this lower line. This is a lower line, so that means you are going to get output as D2 at the output side. See, these two input becomes D0. Let's make it small D0 for the simplicity. So that whenever S1 is 0, your D0, whatever the output comes from this place, that will be appeared at the output side. Similarly, when S2 is 1, whatever the output coming from this multiplex will be appear output side. So when you take 1, 0, your D1, D2 bits will be transferred their respective multiplexer and reach the third multiplexer. The third multiplexer, your S1 is 1. So that means when S1 is 1, your D1, whatever the output comes from this multiplexer, supposed to be transferred. So in this case, your D2 is getting transferred. Similarly, when you take both 1, 1, your D1 and D3 will be transferred to the third multiplexer. Again, your S1 is 1. That means you are going to get your D3 at the output side. So this is how you can use 3 2:1 multiplexer to get the 4:1 multiplexer. This is one way of doing. Or we can also use the enable input for generating higher order marks using the lower order marks. We'll see in a moment. Construction of 4:1 marks using 2:1 marks with the enable input. In the previous case we did not consider any enable. Now we are going to consider the enable input. So in this case, what you do is you are going to use 2:1 marks, for which I am going to connect my D0 and D1 bits. I am going to take one more marks here, in which I am going to connect my D2 to D3 here. So 2:1 marks. So this I am considering as 0, this also is 0. Now there is one enable input here, E. Here also E. Now I'm going to connect this enable input so this is my enable input for both. Instead of E, I'm taking it as S1. Okay, now if you look at here, your S1 are enabled. When this is 0, when S1 are enable is 0, if this is 0, this is your first multiplexer and this is your second multiplexer. When enable is 0, your max 1 will be activated or enabled. When enable is 0 or S1 is 0. Similarly, when S1 or enable is 1, your max 2 will be activated. Please remember, your max 2 will be activated, other will be deactivated. So please remember this one. Now I'm going to consider S0, S1 here, or you can make it as enable / S1. So if I keep both zeros, so enable is 0, that means your first multiplexer will be activated. When first multiplexer is activated and control input of the first multiplexer is 0, that means your output will be, so you're going to take one OR gate to write an output here. So your output will be D0. Similarly, if I take 0 1, again your enable is 0, that means your first multiplexer will be enabled. In that case, your select line as 0 is 1, in that case you are going to get output as D1. Similarly, if I take 1 0, so in this case enable is 1, that means your enable is 1 applied to the second mark, this will be enabled and your multiplex 1 will be disabled. At the same time, your S0 is, that means your D2 will be appeared at the output side. Similarly, when you take both 1 1, since again enable is 1, your lower marks will be enabled and higher marks will be disabled. In this case, your D3, that means your S0 is 1, that means your D3 will be transferred to the output side. Why? So this is how we can use enable input for constructing a higher order marks using a lower order mark. Similarly, we can also construct 8 into 1 marks using 3 into 8 marks, that we will see in a moment. Now we are going to construct 8 into 1 marks using 4 into 1 marks with enable input. We are going to use enable input for designing 8 into 1 marks. So I'm going to take 2 4 into 1 marks. So where I'm going to give my D0, D1, D2 and D3 bits here, or D3 data bits here, and I'm going to take one more here, where I'm going to connect my D4, D5, D6 and D7. And now I'm going to take the select line. You are going to suppose you have 2 select lines, S0, S1. I'm taking directly here also S0, S1. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take enable as one input for both the multiplexers. So I'm going to use enable input for both the multiplexers. Okay, so your S0 is common for both, S1 also common, as well as enable also common. That means my select line becomes S0, S1, enable we consider as S2. Now your enable act as a one more select line. We're going to use a NOT gate here. Okay. Now I'm going to take output of this and output of this and connect it to a OR gate. And this is my output. Now we'll try to see when S0, S1 and S2, or you can call the enable slash this one. When enable is 0, or we'll write the all possible combination. We'll write 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 10011. If you look at here, the first 4 possible combination, where enable is 0, when enable is 0, this 0 becomes 1 here. That means your first 4 into 1 marks will be activated and second one will be deactivated. Please listen, when E is 0, your marks 1 will be activated. Okay, similarly, if you write other possible combination, it will be 100, 101, 110 and 111. In the second 4 combination, if you look at here, your enable is 1, so that means when enable is 1, your enable 1 will directly appear to the lower marks. That means your marks 2 will be activated, and your marks 1 will be deactivated. So if you look at the first 4 possible combination, for these 4 possible combination where your enable is 0, that means your first marks will be activated. And if you look at here, when it is 0 0, your D0 will be transferred here, the same D0 will be appeared at the output side. In the next combination, your 0 0 0 1, that means again your higher order marks, that means the upper marks will be activated, and 0 1 means D1 will be output. And similarly 0 1 0, that means your D2 will be outside, and 0 1 1, that means again this marks will be activated, 1 1 means your D3 will be activated and goes to here and appear at the output side. That means your output will be D0, D1, D2 and D3, as long as your enable is 0. your upper mux inputs are transferred to the output side based on the S1 and S0 inputs. Okay. At the same time, when enable is 0, this entire 4 and 1 mux will be deactivated. It's going to produce 0 for all the combinations of S1 and S0. Now, if I make enable is 1, so that means this becomes 0. That means this will be deactivated and you're going to activate the lower mux. In this case, based on S0 and S1, your input will be transferred to the output side. So if I make both 0, 0, if you look at here, your enable is 1, that means this is enabled, and both are 0, 0, your D4 will be appear at the output side. When 0, 1, D5 will be appeared. When D6, when 1, 0, D6 will be appeared. When both are 1, 1, your D7 will be appeared at the output side. In all these four cases, your upper mux will be disabled and here it's going to produce 0 output here. 0 will be transferred here. Whereas in lower mux, depending on your S0 and S1, your D4 will be transferred, D6 or D7 will be done. The same will be appeared at the output side. This is how we can construct higher order mux using a lower order mux with a enable input, or construction of 16 into 1 by 18 into 1 mux by 4 into 1 mux as a homework. So you could take 16 into 1 mux by 18 into 1 mux with enable, as well as without enable. So you can take this task as a homework or practice kind of thing, and you try to do it on your own. So this all about designing higher order mux using lower order mux. Now we'll try to see the same with a simulation. Let's start with 4 into 1 mux using 2 into 1 mux. As we discussed in the theory, you can see here. So this will be 4 into 1 mux by using 2 into 1 mux. If you look at here, this is first mux. I made my inputs D0, D1 to the first mux, and D2, D3 to the second mux. I taken S0 as common for both the multiplexer. That means S0 will apply here as well as here, and taken one more multiplexer and taken S0 as S1 as this select line, and this is your output. If you look at here, the moment your S0 and S1 both are 1, 1, if you look at here, since this is 0, this line is enabled. Since this is also 0, this line is enabled. But if you look at the second multiplexer line, you can see here, if this is 0, that means only this line is enabled. That means whatever the D0 is transferred through this multiplexer, travel here and reach here, and finally appear at the output side if both are 0, 0. If I change D0 bit, it will be appear at the output side. That means your 4 into 1 multiplexer action is taking place. If I make 1 now, that means 0, 1. So you can, if you look at here, your 1 bit is your D1 and D3 is activated, but D1 is transferred to here, and here it is 0. That means your D1 will be appeared at the output side. If I make any change in the D1, the same change will be reflected at the output side. If you do any change here, this will not reflect at the output side. Now let us make S1 is 1 and S0 is 0. So in this case, if you look at here, since S0 is 0 for both the multiplexer, so you're going to enable D0 output, D0 input and D2 input here. Your D0 input will appear here, and your D2 input will appear here. But since select line S1 is 1, so it is going to select the second input of this multiplexer. There's nothing but your D2. That means whatever the D2 appearing here, the same D2 will be will pass through this multiplexer. The same input will be passed through the second multiplexer, and you are going to see the D2 output here when you are having combination 1, 0. So if I make any change in the D2, that will be reflected at the output side. You can see here, the moment I change the D2, it is going to change at the output side. If I make both 1, 1, if you look at here, your D1 bit and D3 bits are enabled. That means D1 will appear here and D3 will appear here. But second multiplexer will enable only this, whatever the output is going to appear, that will appear as input for this multiplexer. This will be appear at the output side. That means nothing but if you take the trace here, it will be D3. That means when you have both 1, 1, your D3 will be appear at the output side. If I make any change in the D3, that will appear at the output side. You can clearly see. If you do any change in the other bits, it's not going to affect the output, because those inputs are not selected by your select line. This is how you can construct a 4 into 1 mux using 2 into 1. Now we'll try to see what are the applications of multiplexers. Now we'll try to see the applications of multiplexers. First application is used for the data selector. Second use is you can use for implementing the logic functions. We will see. We can also use multiplex for implementing logic functions. We can also use for converting parallel data to serial data. So all these applications will be covered by the time you finish your multiplexer lecture. Now coming to the application of multiplexer. Multiplexer can be used for the data selector, as well as you can use for the implementing logic functions, or you can convert parallel data to serial data, or you can also use for the waveform generation. Data selector application, we have seen how your multiplexer is selecting one particular input data to the output side. So this then no need to discuss once again. I'm going to show you how to implement logic function using multiplexer. Let's take a simple example of a logic function. Let's take simple example for implementing logic. Let's take a logic function as A XOR B XOR C. So that means your logic, your circuit will have three inputs and one output, and both are all zeros, 001, 010, 011, and 100, 101, 110, and all one. So if I look at the expression for A XOR B XOR C, 0 1 0 1, so 010 will be 1, 011 will be 0, 100 will be 1 0 0, and 1. You know A XOR B XOR C, odd number of ones produce output 1, and even number of ones produce output 0. So that's how I took the output. Okay, now I'm going to implement this logic function using multiplexer. If you look at here, you have 8 possible combinations. That means you're supposed to use 8 into 1 mux so that you can have all the 8 possible combinations and you are going to have one output. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take 8 into 1 multiplexer. And I'm going to take select lines here this time for a simple understanding. S0, S1, and S2, S3, or you can rename it as A, C, B, and A. Here A is MSB and C is LSB. I'm going to take my data here, D0, D1, D2, D3, D4, D5, D6, and D7. So if you look at here, I'm going to have output. This will be D0, D1, D2, D3, and D4, D5, D6, and D7. So wherever you have output 1, that means D7, D4, D1, and D2. So what you do is D0, D1. So wherever your output is 1, you connect those inputs to the logic 1 or VC. That means you connect D1, D2, then D4, then D7 to VCC, or 1, and rest you connect to the ground whatever leftover you just connect it to the ground. So this becomes a zero. Okay, now this will be 18 to 1 marks, and you are going to get output Y. If you look at here, when I keep S0, S1, S2, there's nothing but A, there's nothing but A, B, C. If I take all the zeros, so your D0 will be up at the output side, that means your output Y will be D0. So D0 is nothing but 0. If I take 0, 0, 1, in this case your D1 will be up at the output side, D1 is nothing but 1. Similarly, if I take 0, 1, 0, that means your D2 will be up here, that D2 is nothing but 1. Similarly, if you take 0, 1, 1, in this case your D3 will be up here, D3 is connected to the ground, that means you are going to get D3 is 0. If you look at output here, 0, 1, 1, 0, here also 0, 1, 1, 0, that means your 18 to 1 multiplexer is acting as a logic function. Okay, your A XR B XR C is getting produced by your 18 to 1 marks, and you are using your select lines as your ABC inputs. This is how you are going to produce the logic function generation using a multiplexer. I am going to take one more example to make it even more clear. Let's take a simple example. Let's take F equals AB. So you are having AB and output here. Suppose you are taking 0, 0 will be 0, 0, 1 will be 0, 1, 0 will be 0, and 1, 1 will be 1. This is my logic function, this is the corresponding output. Now I am going to implement this logic function using multiplexer. So if you look at here, I need, there are two inputs, that means I need at least 4 inputs. Okay, that means you can use 4 into 1 multiplexer. So if I make it 4 into 1 multiplexer here, so I am going to take my select lines here, your S0, S1, and I am going to take my D0, D1, D2 and D3. So instead of S0, I am making this as B and this is A, so that it will be easy. Now wherever your output is 1, that particular port is connected to the power supply or VCC, that means nothing but 1, and whichever is not having output 1, you are going to keep it as wherever you are having output 0, those ports will be connected to ground, you can equal 0, this will be your D0, D1, D2 and D3. You can see your D3 is connected to VCC, and D0, D1, D2 will be connected to the ground. And this is my 4 into 1 marks, and this is my output Y. This is my output Y. Now if you look at here, your S0, S1 is nothing but your B and A. If I make both 0, 0 and both are 0, 0, your D0 will be appear output, so that means your output will be 0, this is nothing but your D0 bit. And if I make 0, 1, your D1 will appear again, it will be 0. And 1, 0, you are going to get 0, that will be your D2. And 1, 1 will be D3, D3 is connected to 1, that means you are going to get 1 output. So this will be your D3. If you look at here, so whatever the F equals AB logic function, the same thing is implemented by using 4 into 1 marks by simply considering your control input as your A and B inputs, and you can able to see your logic function, implementation is taking place very perfectly. Only thing is you need to connect your data bits appropriately so that it's supposed to produce either 0 or 1. If you want to produce 1, you connect it to the VCC. If you want to produce 0, you connect it to the ground. This is how you can implement a logic function by using multiplexer. Now we'll try to see how to convert a parallel data to the serial data. Now we'll see the second application, parallel data to serial data. So if you look at any multiplexer, let's take 18 to 1 multiplexer for the simplicity. So this is my multiplexer. Now I'm having my data bits D0 to d8 here, so d7, and I'm having my select lines here s0 to s3, s0 to s2. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to connect these select lines to a simple counter circuit, a simple counter circuit which will generate 0 to 7 binary counts. That means this circuit will produce first 00, then 001, then 010, then 011, then 100, 101, 110, and 11. So your counter circuit is going to produce a binary sequence of inputs. Those inputs are applied to the control input of 18 to 1 mux. So when it is 00, your D0 bit will be out first. When it is 001, your D1 bit will be out. When 010, D2, then D3 and D4 and so on, D7. If you look at here, your parallel data, here it is parallel. This is your parallel data. Your parallel data is transferred in a serial fashion, the D0 first and D7 last, with a sequence of bits from 0 to 7. So you are supposed to apply a sequence of binary inputs. That's why I'm using a counter, or you can also manually change from all zeros to 001, then 010, and so on to 7. So when you finish one full cycle, your 8-bit data, 8-bit parallel data will be converted into the 8-bit serial data. This will be D0 bit and this here D7 bit. In the next cycle, again new set of D0 to D7 will be transferred to the other side. This is how you can use your multiplexer for converting a parallel data to the serial data. Now we'll try to see how to generate the waveform using the multiplexer. So we are going to use 18 to 1 multiplexer for the simplicity. So my 18 to 1 multiplexer having 8 data bits. What I'm going to do is, this time instead of keeping some arbitrary bits, I'm going to make 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, then again 1. Okay, so I'm applying my D0 to D7 bits with alternate 0 and 1. I'm going to take my select lines here, S0, S1 and S2, and these select lines again will be connected to a counter circuit which produce 0 to 7 binary inputs. That means your S0, S1 will take from 00 to 11 input in a sequence fashion. When the sequence is taking place right from 0 to 7, first you are going to get 0 output. That will be your D0. When it goes to, suppose you are having all zeros, your D0 will be appeared. Your D0 nothing but all zeros. The moment it goes to 001, your D1 will appear. That means your D1 is 1. That means it goes to up and stay here. When your select bit becomes 010, again it goes to D2 bit, again it goes to 0. Again it goes to 011, it goes to D3. And your D3 is, when it becomes 011, it goes to, so this will be your D0, D1. And D2 and D3 and again D4, D5 and so on. So this is how, when you apply inputs as 0101 in a sequence fashion for the data bits for the 18 to 1 multiplexer, when you apply the sequential control inputs right from 00 to all ones in a sequence fashion, you are going to get the output in the form of zeros and ones in a square waveform. Square waveform whose time period will be decided by the counter time period. If the counter produces very fast, you are going to get the waveform also very fast. I mean, like the time period of the square waveform also will be same as your counter, whatever the counter which is going to produce the sequence of bits. This is how we can use 18 to 1 multiplexer for the waveform generation. So this is all about your applications of multiplexer. Now we'll try to see. Now we are going to see the IC multiplexer, their pin diagram, and how they are going to generate the output. Now let us talk about the IC multiplexers. So 74151 is 18:1 multiplexer. Similarly, we have another IC 74157. This is a quadruple 2:1 multiplexer. First, we'll see 74151. And this is a pin diagram of your IC, where you have a 8 pin is ground and 16 pin is VCC. And your D0 to D7 are your data lines, and S0 to S2 are your select lines. You have an enable bar. And you have two outputs. Instead of one output, you are having one normal output, one complement output. If you look at the simple block diagram, you can see here 0 to 7 your data lines, here D0 to D7, and S1 to S0 to S2 is your select lines, your enable bar. And you're giving a one normal output, one complement output. So when you, let us take a simple example to understand what is meant by normal output and complement output. If we take select lines all zeros and enable also zero, your D0 bit will be appeared the Y, and D0 bar will be appeared the Y bar outputs. It's only just producing the complement of whatever the data is transferring to the output side. If you look at your circuit diagram, it is same as what we discussed in the previous lecture. Only difference is, instead of using a OR gate to combine all the AND gate inputs, you have used a NOR gate. So the NOR gate output will be Y bar. And if you add one more and NOT gate, it becomes OR gate. That is your normal output Y. So this all about your 74151 IC multiplexer, 18:1 multiplexer. Now I'll show you 74157 quadruple 2:1 multiplexer. So in this, you are going to have a IC in which there are four 2:1 multiplexer. That means you are going to have one select line, one enable. Now look at the diagram here. This is the 74157 IC, and your pin number 1, there's nothing but select input. If you select is 0, your A bits will be transferred, that is A1, A2, A3, A4 will be transferred to the 1, 2, 3, 4 at the output side. When you select is 1, and your B inputs will be transferred to the output side. So your, that means 1A and 1B will form one 2:1 multiplexer, and 2A and 2B will form another 2:1 multiplexer, and 3A and 3B another 2:1 multiplexer, and 4A and 4B will be another multiplexer, and G is your enable line, which enables the entire circuit. If you look at the circuit diagram here, if you look at here, A1 and B1 are forming one 2:1 mux. You can see this is one 2:1 mux, and this line is enable line, and this is my select line. If you look at here, your first AND gate is connected with bubble 1, and second AND gate is bubble twice. That means it becomes normal and applied to the second AND gate. So if I make select is 0, that means this 0 becomes 1. This 1 will be applied to the first AND gate. That means whatever A1, that is appeared at the Y1 place. Similarly, if you look at here, the same 1 is applied to AND gate, top AND gate of the this 2:1 and this 2:1 and this 2:1. That means when select line is 0, you are going to transfer A1, A2, A3 and A4. Similarly, when I select is 1, that means this becomes 0 and this becomes 1. That means you are going to enable the lower AND gate of the all 2:1 multiplexer. In that case, your B1 will be transferred, your B2 will be transferred, B3 will be transferred, and B4 will be transferred. This how your four 2:1 multiplexer, this is one multiplexer, this is another one, this another, this four 2:1 multiplexer will transfer the data. This is all about your 74157. Now we'll try to see the simulation of both the ICs in a moment. Now let us simulate the IC multiplexer. 7415 is a 18:1 multiplexer. So if you look at here, even 74151 has total 8 inputs, D0 to D7. These all the 7 inputs are connected to the 8 different switches, which can be connected to either 0 or 1 by connecting it to the VCC as well as connected to the ground. If you look at here, one row is connected to the VCC and one row is connected to the ground. That means this switch can shuffle between 0 and 1. And if you want to And you can see here in this circuit, these are the data bits, and ABC are the select lines. You can see your select lines also connected to the three switches. That means you can apply all possible combination of your select lines, and your G is nothing but enable bar. So I connected this enable bar to the ground so that your circuit is permanently enabled. A G0 bar is connected to the ground. That means your G0 is connected to the ground. That means your IC is permanently enabled. There is no need to disable, and you have two outputs instead of one output. You are having two outputs. One is direct output. Second one is the complement output. So when this is one, this will be zero. When this is zero, and this will be one. Okay. Now we'll try to execute our multiplexing action by choosing the select lines. First, I am going to choose all zeros. If you look at here, your switches are connected to the lower side. Lower side means zero, and upper side means one. If I make my select line 0 0 0, my D0 bit should be, or D0 line should be activated. So if you look at here, my D0 is 0. That's why you are producing Y is 0. This is a normal output, and this is a complement output. The moment I make D0 to 1, you are going to get Y is red and Y2 will be off. You can see here. So you are now D0 is 1. You can see the output D is 1. I like your output Y also 1. So for the time being, ignore the Y2 output, so just take only Y, so there shouldn't be any confusion. So whatever I change in the D, the same change you can observe at the output side when it is 1 1, and when it is 0 and 0. So this is for all 0. Let's make it all 1. That means you connect your ABC values to all 1s. In this case, your D7 bit will be transferred. So I'm going to make my D7. So if I make D7 1, you can see your D7 is 1 output side, and if you make D7 to 0, you're going to see a 0. If you make any other bits changes, it's not going to affect your output. That means only D7 line, your data 7 is activated through a select lines. If I make 100, that means D4 bit supposed to activate, or D4 supposed to be activated. So if I make D4 any change, you can see here D4 is getting change, or D4 is getting transmitted to the output side. So this is how your IC74151 will act as a multiplexing action of 8 bit through select lines ABC. So it is 18 to 1 multiplexer. Now let's talk about the IC74157, which is a 4 2 into 1 multiplexer. Each multiplexer has two inputs. First multiplexer will have inputs 1A and 1B. Similarly, second one will have 2A and 2B, and similarly third and fourth multiplexer also. You can see here there are four bidirectional switches for A1 to A4, and similarly here four directional bidirectional switches for B1 to B4, and your upper part of the switch is connected to the power supply, and lower part of the switch is connected to the ground, and S0 is my select line, and you can see here G is enabled. Enable is connected to the ground permanently so that my circuit will be always enabled. Now if I make S0 is 0, that means your 1A, 2A, 3A, 4A bits will be appeared at the output of Y1 to Y4. That means for all the 4 multiplexer, upper end gate is enabled when I consider S0 is 0. So if I make any change in the A1 bits, the same change can be observed at the output side. Let's run the simulation. Now all are 0s. If I make A1 1, you can see Y1 is 1. If I make A2 1, your Y2 will be 1. A3 1, Y3 will be 1. And A4 1, Y4 will 1. If I make any changes in the B bits, it's not going to affect the output set, because your B bits related gate is not enabled, because your S0 is 0. If I make A1, A2, 1, 1 and remaining 0, 0, you can clearly see the same is reflecting the output set. If I make my S1 is to 1, in that case, whatever the change is going to happen at the B1 input, that will be affected. Suppose if I B1 make 1 means 1, if I make 0 means 0, similarly B2, B3 already at one place, I am going to make it 0. So you can see here it becomes 0. Similarly B4, so I am going to make all 1. You can see all the B1, B2, B3, B4 are transferred to the output. So if you do any change, the A1 to A4 bits is not going to affect the output. Let me make it by making all B zeros. If I change anything in the A bits or A1 to A4, it's not going to affect the output.
But if you do any small change the B1 to B4 bits, it's going to affect the output because your B1 to B4 related AND gate is activated by a control line S0 is 1. If I make S0 0 and 1, I can select either 1A to 4A or 1B to 4B. This is how your 74157 multiplex 8 data inputs by using 4 2 into 1 multiplexers.